one thinks that it is truly female feminine consciousness that is going to save this world.
When we have finished, once again, the world will be dominated by the Nordic, Aryan, Germanic, Anglo-Saxon white people of this earth.
This beautiful Mother Earth. So women in particularly who are certainly living in a patriarchal world. Maybe that's just a fact.
I think the greatest mistake that Adolf Hitler made was being what in this country would be called a nice guy. He was too soft.
Maybe that's just a fact. And I wonder if there is a reluctance to take the power in life and Well, I think there is, because I think women feel almost on a cellular level. You know, we have an ancient memory of witch hunts, women who were different, women who were extraordinary, were healers that dealt with herbs, were born at the sea.
No,
I look at the first passages, because it is a chance for women to heal themselves, for women to reach out their hands and form sisterhood, for women to get in touch with their bodies.
Your pussy's so wet, your hole so tight, and soft, and wet.
Working with women, getting them back to the earth, back to the source of their power. Women tend somehow to become successful, tend to give away their power in their beauty, for instance. They think that that is something that they don't value anymore, and I don't understand that. I mean, women are magnificently beautiful.
Get down on your
knees! And it is true that beauty is part of your power.
Stop.
Do you realize that there are 60 million women going into menopause right now? And it is so fascinating to me that women who live together tend to bleed together.
Yes.
And it is fascinating to me that women who live together tend to bleed together.
Yes, I know.
That is interesting.
And you really
are
to worry
about
your life.
That's right. And what kind of particular women include from leading women? It is a very, very intimate book.
Hitler.
I work with people as much as I can to try and empower women to, and men too. I do work with men.
And I have to admit, I really feel good.
An understanding of the fears and the powers that women have that are so magical.
Thank you, Ren Andrews. And the book is Women at the Edge of Two Worlds. It is a HarperCollins
book. Thank you. Thank you so much. What a pleasure.
You are listening to 770 Radio KKUM, Minneapolis, St. Paul. That was Speech of the Fire with Janet Macy. It's heard every Saturday morning here at 770 Radio K. Janet Macy is a family journalist in the Department of Family Social Science here at the university. She interviews authors of current books. Here is Baby Snufkin with Genders of the Sea here on 770 Radio K.
one little sniff of pussy and you lose it. One little sniff of pussy. One little sniff of pussy and you lose it. One little sniff of pussy and you lose it.
Described his music once as like what he hears when he's walking down a very busy street and the beautiful experience that he has. And
one little sniff of pussy and you lose it. One little sniff of pussy. Yeah.
Thank you.